According to psychologists, the way you take a bath, walk, and use your phone can say more about your personality than you think. After all, we're all creatures of habit, remember? So, what do yours say about you? Let's find out! Before you learn what your daily choices really mean, be sure to hit subscribe and ring this notification bell to never miss a thing on the bright side of life. Number 1. The way you hold a pen. Putting a pen between your index and middle fingers is a sign of an outgoing person who loves to be surrounded by new people. You're very independent and put your freedom first, which sometimes makes it hard for you to commit to somebody fully. If you hold your pen between your thumb and index finger, you're brutally honest and outstandingly smart. Your curiosity leads you through life. However, you enjoy gathering information way more than actually using it. A thumb wrapped over the index finger while holding a pen signals a sensitive heart. Your main problem is that you tend to overthink things to the point where nothing seems the same anymore. Don't forget that your assumptions aren't necessarily the truth, so don't take things too seriously. Number 2. The way you take a selfie. A 2015 study conducted by Chinese specialists from Nanyang Technological University in Singapore had researchers analyzing 123 selfies taken from Chinese social media. At the end of the study, they found fascinating connections between a person's selfie style and their character. People who usually take pictures from below are friendly and nice. Those who don't like to reveal their private space in the selfie background are conscientious and quick-witted. Displaying positive emotions in most of your selfies means that you're open-minded and ready for new experiences. And the popular duck face turned out to be the favorite selfie style of neurotic and self-conscious people. Number 3. The way you take a bath. The first thing that speaks volumes about you is whether you prefer brisk showers or long, relaxing baths. If you're a lover of showers, you're energetic, quick-witted, and caring. And if you sing during your 5-minute shower, you are also highly creative, confident, and sociable. Getting true happiness out of a lengthy bath reveals a calm and reserved person. It's not easy to make you lose your temper. However, when someone does, it's definitely time for them to run for the hills. If you love to create an atmosphere by lighting candles or using tasty bath bombs, you're a perfectionist who's very attentive to detail. Number 4. The way you walk. Dragging your feet while walking usually signifies a lack of enthusiasm and energy. But in terms of a regular walking style, this shows that you desperately want to change your life and detach from your current reality, but you can't. Maybe it's time to start everything afresh? Heavy stamping indicates a person who strives for power and has quite a short temper. They're the ones that can go to great lengths to achieve what they want without paying attention to the people they may hurt in the process. If you take big steps while walking, you're the king or queen of multitasking. You're always interested in a couple of different things and are brilliant at juggling all of them and getting everything done. Small steps, on the contrary, show your discreetness and caution when approaching new things. You prefer to always be prepared and know your way out before getting even one step closer to a challenge. People with slow and soft steps are perfectly in the middle here. They go with the flow and accept life as it is. They enjoy every day with all its ups and downs and always believe that there's something amazing for everybody just around the corner. So if you need a splash of positivity in your life, they're your people. Number 5. The way you use your phone. Let's say you hold your phone with one hand and type using your thumb. This simple habit indicates that you're charismatic, ambitious, and talented. Your only problem is that you often say exactly what's on your mind, which can sometimes hurt the people you love. Another very popular type of phone usage is holding the phone in one hand but typing with the other. These people are sensitive, imaginative, and caring. However, some people associate their kindness with weakness and try to manipulate them according to their own interests. Last but not least, Holding your phone with both hands and typing with both thumbs detects confident, intelligent, and flexible people. You have high expectations for yourself and others, which can easily lead to utter disappointment when something doesn't go your way. Let it go and try to see beauty in others and, most importantly, your imperfections. Number 6. The Way You Laugh. Elaine Kahn, psychologist and author of 1001 Ways to Reveal Your Personality, names laughter as one of the keys to a person's character. According to her, people who giggle are fun-loving free spirits who see the world in bright colors and can lighten up everybody's mood within seconds. Snorting while laughing suggests that you're rather shy and don't like to draw attention to yourself. You're a modest and noble person who follows the rules and hates injustice. A hearty, deep-seated laugh coming from the belly indicates a bold person who prefers to seize opportunities instead of standing in the corner and waiting for a miracle. They know their worth and are willing to work for their dreams. Loud and contagious laughing is a sign of the life of the party. These people are genuine and aren't afraid to be themselves and show their flaws. They're great friends and wonderful life partners. Laughing under your breath reveals an easygoing, down-to-earth person. You don't take yourself too seriously, and you love a good laugh. At the same time, when the situation calls for it, you can be responsible and serious. Number 7. The Way You Hold Your Cup. Extravagant people who have their pinky out while enjoying a cup of coffee are natural-born leaders. They know exactly what they want and how to get it. At the same time, they have a gentle heart and can find common ground with almost everybody. However, there's still one flaw in this portrait. This type of person can be arrogant and way too self-assured. If you hold your cup with both hands, you're an irreplaceable team player who always has a hilarious comment in store. Plus, you're very adaptable and hardworking, but not very good at leading people. If you want to be in charge one day, you should learn how to make important decisions by yourself. Those who hold their cup by the handle, making a fist with their hand, are extremely calm and cold-hearted. Their impassivity allows them to emerge victorious out of any possible situation. Still, this is the same quality that makes it difficult for people to connect to them emotionally. If you prefer to hold the bottom of your cup, you are quite thoughtful and careful. You listen to your mind first and put logic higher than feelings. But even though it seems like you're doing everything right, it's not uncommon for you to lose exceptional opportunities simply because you're too scared of making a mistake. People who hold their cup by the handle, making a fist but also supporting it from the other side with the other hand, are beautifully endearing and vulnerable. You feel everything so deeply and clearly and try to protect the little child within you at all costs. But don't forget that life can't always be a bed of roses, so you need to learn how to make difficult decisions and protect yourself. Finally, if you're one of those people who holds the cup by its upper side, you're all about comfort and adventure. You're pretty laid back, but still full of energy and excitement for life. The only danger awaiting you is your inability to think things through beforehand, which usually gets you into trouble. Number 8. The Way You Hang Your Toilet Paper. Dr. Gilda Carl, a relationship expert and performance coach, created the toilet paper personality test after asking 2,000 men and women of different ages and ethnicities whether they rolled their toilet paper over or under. The results showed that people who roll their toilet paper over are way more dominant. According to Dr. Carl, people of this type even confess to the compulsion to switch the paper direction in their friends' and family's houses to make it their way. On the other hand, people who roll the toilet paper under are submissive and don't mind taking second place from time to time. Who knew the toilet paper knows all our secrets? Did any of these descriptions match your personality? Tell us in the comment section below. And about where you stand on the toilet paper debate. Don't forget to give this video a like, share it with your friends, and click subscribe. Stay on the bright side.